So first we can write down the partial orders that we see in the distributed system. You can see that A happens before B, B happens before C, C happens before E. And these are purely coming from the chain of communication and local events that are happening over here. When we come over here, we also observe that F happens before E. That's because of the sequentiality of this process. And similarly, we can see that in process P1, A happens before D. So these are the partial orders, and we already have an ordering for the events that follow this chain because the logical timestamp are assigned in this fashion. And in order to derive a total order, we said we basically will believe the event timestamps to order them totally. So we can order these events totally, A1, B2, C3, E5, we can order them totally. Now let's look at the concurrent events that are happening. The concurrent events that are happening is D over here is concurrent with all the other events in the other processes. D is concurrent with B and C, it is concurrent with F and E. And similarly, if you look at this event F, it's concurrent with all the events that are happening in process P2 and P1, right? So this is what you see as the concurrent events. So now what we have to do is, given that these are concurrent events, we have to somehow fit them into a total order. As I said before, no problem in fitting these guys in the total order because they already have timestamps that distinguish them from one another. The timestamp associated with A is 1, B is 2, C is 3, E is 5. No problem with that. So the real problem comes with F and D. Now the sequentiality of this process is what made the timestamp associated with E to be 5, because the message that came over here had a timestamp of 3, but we associated a timestamp of 5 with E because the local event preceding E had a timestamp of 4. So we picked 5 as a timestamp to associate with E so that the sequentiality of this process P3 is respected. So we've got this, and now we've got F and D, and so F obviously is going to sneak in before E. That's no problem. That is coming from the sequentiality. But where will we put D? Should we put D after E, or should we put D before E in the total order? This is where the breaking the tie using process ID comes into play. Because these two guys are concurrent events in the system, we're breaking the tie using the process ID. P1 happens to be less than P3 in process ID space, and therefore we're going to say that in the total order, D is going to be ahead, totally ordered before E. So the final ordering that we end up with, the total order that we end up with is A, B, C, F, and then D, and then E. So that's the total order that we come up with, respecting the logical timestamp associated with the events and breaking the tie using the process ID.